take the moon, a little unsteady in the contact, felt not quite balanced. Six, five. Neck over bent. Knees push and less speed. Not always regular. Six. Show more difference. Six. Bending, not enough angle. 5.5. Unsteady in the contact at times behind vertical. 6.5. Needs more angle. Overbending in neck. 6. Low, overbending, six point five. Be even more clear, 6.5. At times behind vertical. Hurry, needs more angle, 6. Circle slightly large, but well balanced, 7.5. Overbending, pull low, angle faded, 5. Rock steps to halt. Reluctant RB. Too many steps. 5. Behind vertical, overbending neck, 6.5. Hesitant, losing activity at start, 6.5. Rhythm varies, pull low throughout, 6. Must show steady, down and forward stretch, in free walk, jigged, 4.5, and less speed against hand, bobbled after R, 5.5, unclear, 5.5. Losing collection, hurry. Switched leads behind, 5.5. Simple change before L, 6.5. Crooked, quarters to right. Clean change. Trouble. 4. Really not shown at F, 5.5. Should be 3 equal 20 meter half circles with better collection. Better last loop, 6.5. Swapped leads. Stopped, 5. Seven. A bit strong and against hand, but straight. Fairly balanced, fairly well balanced halt, 7.5. He's an athletic little boy, and he can do a lot of things, and he wants to show all of them. In general, what I, you know, and I don't know this horse really at all, but in general today, he seems to be a little too much low in the pole, coming behind the vertical and overbending his neck. When that's happening, and the neck is up and behind the vertical, if the neck is coming back, the hind legs can't go forward because the back is down. And it, I think, that this horse could have a much more scopey cadence trot. You know, he was a little quick and against your hand, at least today he seems that way. And I don't know if this is typical.
This is the horse show horse.
Okay. The throughness is not, at least in this horse show horse day, he's not through enough. He's not over his back to the contact equally on both sides. I just would like to play with some things on the circle, please, on the left rein, 20 meter circle. And just let him walk a bit. And as you're walking, I want you to think a thought of shoulder 4. He's very interested to know about what other horses are doing, you know. When Lisa walked the horse by, he started swapping leads right away and things like that. And is that typical at a horse show?
Yes.
Okay. So, to me, especially at a horse show, you have to protect the lead more. In other words, your legs did not say to him to stay. In other words, your leg, no matter what lead you were on, I really watched, and you didn't protect the lead too well with your legs. You know, it could be that his tension is escalated to the point where it really doesn't matter. I'm not saying it would help completely, but I want to just play with a couple of things in terms of his positioning. I can see in the cervical vertebrae, maybe, I don't know which one it is, fifth or sixth back, that he's used to overbending his neck there. I can see it in the musculature how it is. Am I right?
Yes.
Okay. So to me, if I had this horse to help, the first thing I would do is try to get his neck out and more forward and less behind the vertical so he has more chance to swing in his back. Go ahead and trot rising. Did you feel like you had enough warm-up? Okay.
I just knew that being here, it's nice and open, that he would probably have issues.
I want you to push him slower with outside flexion. Flex him to the right until his pole comes up and he doesn't come with his chin on his chest. Okay, Rob, tell me something. When I ask you to flex him to the right, what do you do?
I sponge in my right hand, I soften in my left rein, and I was putting my right leg on to basically...
Okay, I'm coming down here to show you something.
Perfect.
Are you very excited?
Keep his neck straight with your left rein. Flex him right and do some soft turns in. But as you do it, really feel your contact on both sides and push him slower. Yeah? More length in the neck. Try to get his nose out. And make a square.
Got it.
That's it. I want his pull up and his nose out, not his nose in and his neck overbent. Push him slower, let his nose out, half halt. Yeah. Better. Cadence. I want to see cadence, not speed. And make another turn in a square. Slow. Good. This will only get better, I promise. Now sit more securely and change rein. As you make your change of rein, make a square the other way. Slow. Push him slower. Don't restrict the neck. Give him the benefit of the doubt. As you make your flexion left, don't lose your right rein. Good. Good. Slow down. Yes, and don't look at your flexion, because that changes your shoulders. I want his pull up and his nose out, not his nose in and his neck overbent. So push him slower. Use your leg. Walk. It's okay. You know, this is a process. It's not going to be, okay, ta-da. You know what I mean? Let his nose out and his pull up. Soften the hand. You've got a very nice position. Good. Trot rising. Or no, you can sit or pose, whatever you want. Good. Now let the neck out more. He's still overbending. Post for a minute. Push your hands forward. I want to see something. Now do a square. So there's a lot of work to do because he literally has grown a huge muscle in that area of his neck when he's overbending. You know what I'm saying? It takes a while to fix this. Good. Push him out with your leg. Push his nose out with your leg. Yep. Half halt. Half halt. Half halt. Don't let him go. Yes. Good. Good. Do that again. Good. Now bend him right. Flex him right. Bend him right. Nice. Push him slower. Spiral into a smaller circle. Half halt. Nice. Hands down. Yes. That's more correct in the neck. Good. Walk with your leg open. Close your thigh. Good. Beautiful transition. Trot. Keep his neck out, his pull up. Trot. Good. Soft hand, hands low. Flex left. Push him slower. Get his pull up and his nose out. Position him to the right. Nice. Keep his neck there. That tempo's fine. You don't have to go Mach 10 tail on fire to be correct. Kenner. Soft, easy, protect the lead. Yes, super. Now make a square in the Kenner. Keep his pull up and his nose out. Flex him right when he gets distracted. You're in charge of that. Keep him bent right. Protect the lead with your leg. Make sure that inner leg from your hip down is on his side. Make sure your left leg is back to protect the left lead, which it is not. You understand what I'm saying? You had a mess of Bush United and funny kind of things going on, but I did not see enough change in your leg. This is prettier. Trot with your leg. Yes, now flex left. Don't let him dump you. Push him slower with his pull up and his nose out. Push him slower. Slow down. Half halt, half halt, half halt. Thank you. Aha, you got him there. Change rein, slow down. Hip His focus is changing right now. Do you feel that?
Yes.
Change direction gently, gently. Change the direction with your leg and your back, not your hands. I love it. Yes. Slow down, shorten your contact. Protect the hook, protect the bend with your leg. Yes. Good. Pull up, nose out, otherwise it's incorrect in the neck. Half halt. Slow down. Nice. Prepare for left canter. And when you're ready, canter left. That was really pretty. Tactful and pretty. Now make a square. Slow down. Nose out. Slow half halt. Don't lean behind him with your upper body. He doesn't need you to be in the back seat. He needs you to be supporting him. And your right leg is too far forward. I would be confused if I were him. You're not protecting the lead enough with your seat and your leg. Good. Half halt. Half halt, give. It's the give that creates the give in him, not the holding. Half halt, then soften. Beautiful. Doesn't matter. Good. Pull up. I don't like how the neck is there. Slow down. Pull up. There. Good.
Boy.
Well done.
Good boy.
Very nice. It's okay. Kenner. Soft, easy, harmony. Good. Allow him to balance. Good. Now, your reins got too long and you started leaning behind him too far. Sit up. Straight. Spiral into a smaller circle. Slow down. Half halt. Give it. Make three half halts in a row with a tiny give afterwards. Leg. Keep your leg supporting the canter. Half halt, give. Slow down. Make a square. Make a square turn. Half halt. Give. Push him slower. Get his pull up. Soften your hand after. Make him sit more on the hind leg. Yes. You feel that?
Yep.
Trot. Doesn't matter. No big deal. Up. I still don't see enough change in your leg and your canter. Your outside leg is still too far back. I mean forward.
Oh, okay.
Sorry. Canter. Move a bit. Half halt. Flex right. Slow down. Canter in place without the pole going behind the vertical. That means you're going to have to put your leg on. He needs you to be there. Leg, 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 leg. Thank you. Leg, leg, leg. Yes. He says, holy cow, I've got a support weight. Do you feel that?
Yes.
You've got to make him sit and take more responsibility with his hind legs. Change rein through the diagonal at X, trot. Lower bent. Slow it down. Push his neck out. Good. Down the long side without overbending the neck, shoulder in. Slow down. Thank you. From the rhythm comes the balance. Don't be in a hurry. Now you developed it, but now the pole's overbent. I mean, the pole's low and the nose is behind the vertical. You feel that? I want you to do Ron Bear down the next long side to try to get the pull up.
And what did you say that again?
Ron Bear.
Got it.
Half halt, give. I want that pull up to get rid of that bulging muscle in the wrong place. Pull up, nose out. Don't bend them so much with your left rein. Take the shoulders more to the right. Keep your right leg back. Put your inner leg more on at the girth. Half halt. There. Better. Down the long side, I want a circle of 10 meters at K, followed by a correct shoulder in with the nose not on the chest. He's used to it. I can see it by his musculature in the neck. You gotta fix it. It's gonna take a little bit of time. There. Push him up. Yeah, slow. Good. shoulder in. Slow. Better. Half out, half out, half out, half out. As Robert Dover says, you're one half out away from perfect. Better in the temple. You feel that? There! You have to allow him to balance, not run him off his feet with his nose on his chest.
Okay.
Diagonal change rein. Nice. Hands down. Fingers talking to him. Your fingers must negotiate. Not your arms so much. Now he's going to the vertical pull is dropped. Put your leg on and half out. Thank you. Down the next line side, shoulder in left. Good. Beautiful. 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 Yes. Shoulder in. Now, turn left. You know why I'm having you repeat that? Is because you didn't prepare him for that. You just pushed him into it. But I love the neck there. That's fantastic. Slow down. Now bend him. Use your corner as your friend. So you don't surprise him into the shoulder in. Better than the first one. Slow, 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 half out. Where's your legs? Are you leaning behind the vertical? There, better, better. Circle this end. You just pull up and his nose out and slow down and use your leg and half out. And yes. I love it. I love it. Walk. Headed. My goodness, he's so pretty when you have his neck correct. Do you feel what I'm talking about? Okay. And then it all comes in a nice cadence with some flow and some rhythm and not just da-da-da-da-da-da speed, you know? You cannot balance him if his neck is short and his steps are so fast. And the difference visually to me was night and day. And he and he can do it. And your canter became more uphill and expressive with some more cadence and more lift and more uphill balance. And, you know, for second level, you don't have to have uphill balance every step. It can be a little horizontal to uphill. It's not like a requirement like it starts to be in third level. But this horse is talented enough that he can show uphill balance throughout the test. Am I making sense?
Absolutely. So, absolutely, and I felt that at the end of this, I had a different horse, but also what happened is the tension went down in him.
Amen.
Okay.
Amen.
How do I get that at the start of my test or in my warm-up?
See, it's a process. Okay. If I had looked at this horse and I didn't see the bulging muscle down on the fifth or sixth cervical vertebrae and feel it with my own hands, I would say that it's a, I always say that it's a matter of redeveloping the correct muscles where they're lacking or need some more strength.
Mm-hmm.
When you have that, then your question will not be asked because you'll be riding him with that kind of beautiful cadence and balance. So to say, do this and that's all going to go away immediately is stupid on my part because you have to retrain some of these muscles to be able to be strong enough to hold that kind of balance, which you want. If he's ridden like that all the time, he's going to go that way whether you're in a horse show, warming up, or standing on your head because he's going to have those muscles ready for you to use. Right now, he doesn't. He's weak. I always look at the horses in three sections in terms of connection, hind leg, middle, and neck, shoulder.
Mm-hmm.
He is weak behind the saddle, and he is weak in the neck. So those two pieces have to be connected from behind over the back to the bit
to
in order to have consistency. I really think you can get it with him pretty darn easily, though.
Okay.
So it's a process. I mean, it's a longer period of time than I have at the moment to get, you know, the plan, come back and let's do this again from the warm-up on, you know, because this shows you, I think there was a huge difference between the first trot and the canter and the later trot canter.
I'm
And, you know, that's, I'm thrilled that he was able to fix that neck and become more cadenced and more relaxed. And he got only better and better and better and better.
And then it got easier for me to ride.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But it all goes together, right?
Yes.
Yeah. He's a great horse and you're a good rider.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Video.